Hiya, I'm Pimmy. I was asked to show how I dress my distaff for the medieval spindling and what my distaff looks like undressed. I don't have a fancy distaff. There are really nice ones with carving up the top and a stick and widening into a little plank. Or with kind of a wicker basket or other contraptions on top. I don't have any of those. I just have a hazel stick. Also the reason that we're sitting outside this morning instead of in the yard is because the cat wouldn't let me go inside, and after I had my breakfast with him, he decided to go and nap on my prepared wool. So I'll have to go and disappoint him in a bit. Let's see if I can get the tripod to stay. Yes. My distaff is just a piece of hazels, the new sprouted branches are really straight and go up before they start in the second or third year, start to branch out. And I cut those to size and peel the bark off of this. And for me, the right length is about armpit height, maybe a bit lower. So I need to cut this one to size, because I don't know where I left my good one, and the one I used last time is, as you can see, way too short for me, and also all the twists and corners in it make it difficult to position. So this one I'll peel and make it nicer looking, but for now just cutting it off at about armpit height, a bit lower will do. And then, because I don't have the nice things on top, I need something to secure my yarn with, of my fiber with. And for this I am going to cut a little groove, a little notch here around the top. Not too much, not too deep. Just so that a piece of string will stay there. If I tie it around here, right. So little notch, and I use two kinds, because I had to figure all this out by myself. I didn't have a tradition of distaffs around me to learn from. So one way I use is to just tie a knot in in that notch and secure the fiber with that. And the other one is to have a piece of string, a piece of what you call it? Well, a little band, a ribbon, that's the word. Secure that on the top. Wrap that over, spiral it downwards over the fiber and up again, and tie it off at the top. And it will be easier if I leave this a bit longer, because I can tie it off with the other end. Yes, I'm very well prepared this morning. I didn't think this through. But I only recently started to do the spiral down, spiral up again with just one length of ribbon. Because my friend Ineke found out how that worked. And you don't have the... before that I had two pieces of string coming down and spiraling in the opposite direction, and then I had my knot at the bottom of the wool supply, and it's always in the way. So just one length spiraling down and spiraling up again works way better. Now I'm going to have to disappoint my cat and ask him to leave, because I want the wool back. But first, let me steal one piece from him. I have here some combed, hand-combed fiber. This is a down wool, because that's what I have lots of. And this is tessel, and I combed it with some Louette mini combs, which I'm not all that fond of, because the tines are too flexible and they bend out of shape. You can see it here on the side, they stick out. And they are very delicate, and I would rather have a bit more sturdy combs. But because I use a short wool and not the long wools like you do with if you start combing wool with the big English combs that have three or four sets of tines going tapering off like this in length, then you need a really long wool to comb with those, and those are perfect for long wool, but I don't have long wool, so smaller combs are better for me. Let's see if I can show the wool. A lock for me is about this length, so it's really, really short. Doesn't work all too well with anything bigger than a mini comb. But I end up with about this amount of wool. This amount of pulled fiber, if I pull it off the combs. Now I have to get my wool from underneath my cat. Poes, het spijt mij, maar ik heb deze nodig. Nou, let's tilt this down a bit. I have a pile of these combed bits of wool, and I'll put them down next to each other. Nee, poes, gaat niet lukken. Doe maar. Is it still visible? I think. Helpful cats. And I have two others that I am going to put underneath at an angle. Well, what you call it? The other way around. Which will kind of act like a belt that I'm going to roll the fiber over. So these are about halfway halfway in the wall. Does this work better? I hope. I am going to roll it up over the belt, keeping it quite tight, and I'll fold it over this belt bit, and this is the makeup of the wool, the construction that I'm going to put on the this stuff. So this stuff, and I am putting the top part of the wool, folded over wool, about the same height as the end of the distaff, and I'm spiraling down, but I also turn the ribbon around the stick. You see it here. To secure it tightly to the stick without having to squish all the air out of my wool, because if I tie it too tight to the stick, then it won't draft down easy enough. So I'm turning around the distaff and going down again. Back up. To meet the other bit near the top. And I have my fiber secured, and I can spin from down here. If I spin this down, this bottom part, I can just unspiral and untie this, and take this one off and put it up a bit higher, and I have fiber again to spin, working my way up till I am at the band bit, but I have been able to just spin up the entire fiber supply and just tighten it up at the top a bit as I reach that. And yeah, this works for me. It's probably not a very traditional way of using, making up a distaff, dressing a distaff, but it works for what I have and how I use it. You can also do it with a carded bat. And if you lay that out and split it lengthwise, use that instead of the hand-combed strips. And you can probably use a commercial top as well, but the times I have tried that, it was too slick and too loose. It didn't stay together. So maybe if you steam or dampen it or dye it first, so it's been wet and the crimp of the fibers come back in the top again, maybe then it works better. But for me, I want a little bit of resistance to pull against, but yep. Perhaps you could just tie it on tighter and that would work. But this is what I use. So I hope that this was enough information to get you started. And hope to see you next time. Bye.